Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Engineering Made Simple. Now as you know, we were studying wireless networks course. Now in this course we are going to start a new topic today, which is wireless local area network. And wireless local area networks are defined in IEEE 802.11. That's the reason it is known as IEEE 802.11. We are going to cover the topic of WLAN in parts. So this is the part one of wireless local area networks topic. Now next, so let's start with the introduction. Before we understand what are wireless LANs, that is WLANs in short, we will first understand briefly what do you mean by wired LAN. Now everybody knows what is a wired LAN. Wired local area network we see extensively in our day-to-day lives. So a wired local area network, that is wired LAN, consists of a backbone cable which is laid underground and it connects through university, college campuses or government offices and so on. So what are the main components of a wired LAN? Here we have a LAN adapter, that is wired LAN local area network adapter, and different workstations. By meaning workstations, meaning the different computers or network devices which can connect to the said wired LAN. And it consists of a server. Now in our day, in your college campus also, you have seen a computer lab which consists of a LAN ports through which you can access the college's wired local area network. So that is a wired LAN. But the main disadvantage of this wired LAN is that you can't move along with your system. Suppose thing you are doing something in your computer laboratory, for you are researching for your project, and you have connected your laptop to the LAN cable of the college's wired local area network. But the problem with this is you can't move from one place to another while you are browsing. So it is a fixed network, fixed connection, and user cannot move its system from it in order to stay connected. So the need arises for a wireless local area network technology. So because of mobility issues, we move from wired LANs to wireless LANs. So wireless LANs are nothing but LAN without wires, that is local area network without wires. So let's start. With the success of wired local area networks everywhere, the world is moving towards wireless LANs. Wireless LANs are flexible data communication systems that can be used for applications in which mobility is required. Now this point is the same which I had explained in the example earlier, because with wired LANs, user cannot move from one place to another as its device is connected to the network via cable. So it's impossible for him to move. That is a fixed line communication. And the wireless LANs provides this flexibility because it is a wireless network and anybody can connect to the network if you have network access. So wireless LANs are designed to operate in the industrial, scientific and medical ISM radio bands and unlicensed National Information Infrastructure UNII bands in the United States. Now currently wireless LAN provides data rates or data transfer speeds up to 11 Mbps, but the industry is making a move towards high speed LANs which can provide data rates up to 54 Mbps. So the IEEE 802.11 committee is a committee which is responsible for designing various WLAN standards. What do you mean by designing various WLAN standard? In those standards, for every technology, some network model, network architecture or protocol stack will be given, which will be similar to your OSI model protocol stack, or which will be inspired from the OSI model protocol stack for ease of understanding of the people who are designing those technologies. So this IEEE 802.11 committee will give the standards, and in those standards the different technologies will give its own protocol suite. So it will be easier for network engineer to design those systems accordingly, wireless LAN systems accordingly. Now wireless LANs include the following subgroups, that is IEEE 802.11 is the main protocol, is the main standard making committee, but along with this there are some subcommittees also in there. So first subcommittee is IEEE 802.11a, that is Wi-Fi 5. IEEE 802.11b, that is Wi-Fi. IEEE 802.11g, that is IEEE 802.11g, and IEEE 802.11n are the subgroups of IEEE 802.11. Now these two, IEEE 802.11a and IEEE 802.11b, are very familiar to us because these are the same technologies through which we connect to our wireless router. So when you are connecting to your wireless router, one can see these technologies listed on this, that is that it supports IEEE 802.11a/b or and so on. So the deployment or development of WLANs can provide connectivity in homes, factories, and also can act as hotspots through which mobile users can connect to the network anytime. So these are the advantages of using wireless local area networks. So the same subgroups which we discussed earlier are listed here. Now IEEE 802.11 subgroups, which are the subgroups of the IEEE 802.11 committee, which has given us the standard, that is IEEE standard for wireless LAN. So that's the reason we need to study the subgroups in detail as well, which will be covered in the later parts of the lecture. So IEEE 802.11 will be what is the unique feature of IEEE 802.11a? It consists of high speed physical layer in the 5 GHz band. So if we study the protocol stack of IEEE 802.11a, we will come to know that its physical layer operates in 5 GHz band and it provides high data transfer rates. Then 802.11b is another extension of wireless networks in 2.4 GHz band. 802.11d deals with the local and metropolitan area wireless network connectivity. 802.11g deals with broadband wireless communication. So broadband wireless communication, in many routers you see this IEEE subgroup also listed. If you have not seen this, have a look at your wireless router. It will say 802.11a/a/b/g/n. 802.11i subgroup is used when some security requirement is there. And subgroup IEEE 802.11n is used for wideband service. Wideband service in a wireless local area network. So now these are the radio specifications of WLAN, which from the industrial, scientific, and medicine bands. Now one of the salient features of industrial, scientific, and medicine band is that it is an unlicensed spectrum. That is, you need not to pay telecom regulatory authority will not charge you, or you did not need to purchase a license in order to use this frequency bands. So there are four frequency bands which are used, which the wireless local area network technology uses. First band is from 0.902 GHz to 0.928 GHz. Similarly, these are the four bands, you can have a look at it. And what is the bandwidth, that is also listed over here, and what is the power level at which wireless local area networks transmissions takes place, that is also listed. And what is the spread spectrum technique? Now, you might have studied spread spectrum techniques while you are studying your mobile communications course in the sixth semester. So when you are using spread spectrum techniques have the following advantages. When you are using spread spectrum signals have the following advantages. They are more resistant to jamming. They can fight multipath issues also, and at the same time they can be used for various multiple access techniques as well, various spread spectrum techniques. So go through this once. So now let us move on to salient features of WLAN. First feature is, now wireless local area networks combine data connectivity and user mobility. which was a drawback in case of wired LANs. Wired LANs would only provide data connectivity, but it did not provide user mobility. So this was overcome by your wireless LANs, because wireless LANs combine data connectivity with user mobility. The range of a WLAN depends on the actual usage and environment of the system. And the next feature. Now, the coverage radius can vary from 100 feet inside a solid walled building to a several thousand feet in an outdoor environment with direct line of sight. So, one thing important thing to note here is that wireless local area network technology requires a direct line of sight communication. And in case of wired LAN, there was no question of direct line of sight because it was a wired connection. So now standard wireless LANs are capable of operating at speeds in the range of 1 to 2 Mbps depending upon the actual system. Both of these speeds are supported by the standards which are defined by IEEE for WLANs. So there are certain standards which we discussed earlier also, which are defined by the standards making body IEEE. And if you want to know about the standards of the wireless local area networks, you need to study the IEEE 802.11 standards and its subgroups in detail. Now, the next feature, the fastest LANs use 802.11 the high rate standard. What do you mean by high rate standard? High rate standard is a standard which provides high data rates. That is why its name is high rate standard, and it can give speeds up to 11 Mbps. So any wired LAN application or network operating system or protocol, including transmission control protocol / internet protocol, that is TCP/IP, will run on 802.11b compliant wireless LAN as well as Ethernet. So whatever same protocols or technology that you were using in wired LANs, the same can be used on 802.11b compliant wireless LANs as well as Ethernet technologies. So suppose thing, if you are planning to set up a wireless local area network in your office or anywhere else, you need the following wireless local area network equipment, that is WLAN equipment. The following equipment you need if you are interested to set up a WLAN. So first equipment that we need is wireless local area network adapter. Now let us study what is a wireless local area network adapter and what are its functions. So wireless adapters are made in the same basic form as their wired counterparts, that is PCMCIA card, bus, PCI and USB. These were the same components which acted as a local area network adapter when you are dealing with wired LAN. So these wireless adapters are also perform the same function as that of the wired counterparts. That is what is given over here. So they also serve the same function, that is enabling users to access the network. So a LAN card, using a LAN card, a computer or a workstation can connect to a wired LAN. Similarly, if a wireless LAN driver or adapter is installed on your PC, you can connect to equivalent wireless local area network. So that is what is the statement tries to convey over here. So in wireless local area network, they provide the interface between the network operating system and an antenna to create a transparent connection to the network. So it acts as an interface between operating system of the network and antenna. Antenna distributes the network to different users to create a transparent connection to the network. So there is transparency in connection, and it also provides an interface through which one can connect to a wireless LAN. Now next, the next important equipment which we will use when we are setting up a wireless local area network, that is known as access point, AP. Now the AP is a wireless equivalent of the wired LAN hub. It receives data, it buffers data and transmits data between wireless local area network and wired network, supporting a group of wireless user devices. So what does this mean? Access point is nothing but which is similar to a wired switch wireless wired hub. And what are its function? It receives the data, it transmits the data between wireless local area network and wired network, and supports a group of wireless mobile user devices. So suppose thing I have a wireless network setup, then this access point will allow my users which are interested in connecting to the network, which are wireless and mobile, that is, to connect to the network. So an access point is a point that allows the users to access the network. That's the reason it is called an access point. So an access point is typically connected with the backbone network through a standard Ethernet cable, and it communicates with wireless devices by means of an antenna, Ethernet or broadband cable. Now an access point, what is an example of an access point? Simple, everybody has a wireless router nowadays at home. So a backbone cable is connected at the back end of the router to its WAN port, and using the antenna, it distributes the network connection wirelessly to its user devices. So in this case, the Wi-Fi router's antenna will act as an access point, and the backbone cable, which is connected to a backbone cable, which comes from the internet service provider, and which is connected to Wi-Fi router's WAN port. And it distributes the signal wirelessly using antenna. So your Wi-Fi router's antenna will act as an access point. So that is a simple example of what is an access point. So the access point, or alternatively it is also called an antenna, connected to it is generally mounted on a high wall or on the ceiling when you are dealing with wireless local area networks. So, like cellular communications, access points can also support handoffs. So, handoff strategies, why do we do handoff? That you have studied in your semester 6 course, that is mobile communication. So, just as in case of cellular telephony, when a mobile user moves from one coverage radius to another, handoff takes place. Similarly, in case of wireless local area networks, access points do these handoffs. So, access points have a range of 20 to 500 meters and can support between 15 to 250 mobile users depending upon the technology and configuration. And suppose thing, if I want to increase the coverage radius of this access point, I can add more APs to increase the coverage radius. So, if I want to scale up my network, that is wireless local area network, I need to add more access points to the network, existing network. So large networks require multiple APs to create them, APs to, requiring multiple APs deploy them. Large networks which require multiple APs, as I told you earlier, because if you want to increase the coverage radius, and if you are dealing with a large wireless local area network setup, then we need to create overlapping cells for constant connectivity, otherwise connectivity issues will be there. So overlapping cells are generated by using APs or by deploying multiple APs so that there is constant connectivity to the network and connection does not drop because it is a wireless connection, and it is subjected to different types of multipath fading and propagation and so on, similar to what a cellular telephone signal experiences. So a wireless access point can monitor movement of clients across its domain, and it can allow or deny specific traffics or clients when communicating through it. Now this is the same. Now in order to understand this statement, let us take a case of our personal home Wi-Fi router. So a person which has access to your password can access the network through its access point, that is Wi-Fi router's antenna. But if you do not have the Wi-Fi password, then you can't connect to that network. So that's the same thing explained over here. A wireless AP can monitor the movement of a client across its domain or across its coverage radius, and it can permit or deny specific traffic or clients or the data transfer through it. The third equipment which you require is outdoor wireless LAN bridges. Now, when we are dealing with wired LANs, when we are using wired LANs, the problem with it was if I wanted to connect two separate buildings, then I had to connect a wired LAN bridge in between. similar to its wired counterpart, we have wireless LAN bridges. When we want to connect two infrastructures or two offices which are at a distance, or two buildings which are at a distance, wirelessly we make use of wireless LAN bridges. So wireless LAN bridge is nothing but a simple device which is used to connect two different wireless local area networks. So if I have wireless local area network 1 and wireless local area network 2 situated at some distance, then I have to connect a wireless local area network bridge in between them to ensure constant connectivity, or to keep both the wireless local area networks connected to one another. So just as outdoor wired LAN bridges used to connect wired LANs in different buildings, the same is applicable for wireless LAN bridges as well. It is used to connect two or more wireless LANs together. So a wireless LAN bridge can support fairly high data rates and ranges of several miles with the use of line of sight. So line of sight conditions should be maintained in case of wireless LAN bridges also. And the outdoor LAN bridges or wireless LAN bridges makes use of highly directional and line of sight antennas to ensure constant connectivity between two different wireless LANs. So some access point can be also used as a bridge. So access point can be also as a bridge between buildings of relatively close proximity. So if you want to connect two wireless LANs which are not so far from each other or which are in close proximity, you can make use of an access point and connect to the same. So in some cases, outdoor LAN wireless LAN bridges is also not required. If you are working in close proximity, if you want two buildings to communicate with each other, suppose, see, access point can also act as a bridge. That is what I am trying to explain over here. Now, just now we studied different types of wireless local area network equipment which are required when you are setting up a wireless local area network. Now, as you studied different equipments, now let us study different topologies in which a wireless network can be configured, local area network can be configured in. So what is a topology? A topology is nothing but geometric representation of network, and it helps us in understanding how the data transfer takes place between its different network elements. Now, wireless local area networks can be built with the following three topologies. First is the peer-to-peer ad hoc topology. Second is access point based topology. And third is point to multipoint bridge topology. So peer-to-peer ad hoc topology we'll start learning first. Now, as you know, it is a peer-to-peer topology. So these wireless devices with an antenna in blue color, these blue color devices are nothing but clients which are connected using ad hoc topology in a WLAN. Now, this device can communicate to this device, and this device can communicate with these devices as well. There is no order in their communication, and also any device can leave the network at any point of time. So it is known as ad hoc topology. So any client can communicate with another client, and there is no orderly fashion in which they communicate. Only they are connected via same wireless local area network. So if you are setting up a wireless local area network in this type of setup or ad hoc setup, it is said that the wireless local area network is connected in a peer-to-peer fashion, or connected in peer-to-peer ad hoc topology in more technical terms. So what does this mean? Client devices within a cell communicate directly to each other as shown in the figure below. So this is how a peer-to-peer ad hoc topology looks like when you build a LAN, wireless LAN, using peer-to-peer ad hoc topology. Now the second type of topology in which WLAN can be connected is. Now let us study access point based topology. Now if you want to connect a wireless LAN in an access point based topology, you need some backbone wired infrastructure. Now this black colored line which you see is the backbone wired connection to which various wireless access points are connected. But these access points are connected to this backbone cable also by means of a wire or wired connection. But the function of this access points is to distribute the data connection or network connection wirelessly to its intended clients or those devices which are permitted to be part of this wireless local area network or permitted to access the resources of the wireless local area network. So if station 1, station 2 and station 3 are authorized devices which are permitted to use this wireless local area network setup, then they can connect wirelessly using these access points. So this device need not be physically connected to this network cable or backbone cable, but it can access the network while on the go because it is connected to, say, suppose access point 1, connected wirelessly to access point 1. So this is a topology which is a mixed wired and wireless type of a thing. So this is much explained, that this access point based topology is explained much more detail over here. So access point based topology uses access points to bridge traffic onto a wired Ethernet or token link or to a wireless backbone network. An access point enables a wireless client device to communicate with any other wired or wireless device on the network. So from the diagram, this point was pretty much clear, and I had given you the detailed explanation when I was explaining the diagram of access point based topology. So if you have doubt related to it, you can go through the diagram once by seeking the video previously and then understand what is an access point based topology. It will be clearer to you. So the wireless LAN configured in this type of topology does not replace the wired LAN entirely. It extends connectivity to mobile devices. So that was pretty much clear from the diagram as well. Now the third and the last topology in which a wireless local area network can be connected is point to multipoint bridge topology. What is a point to multipoint? Suppose one device can connect to 10 other devices, that is point to multipoint. And bridge topology meaning, if there are two different wireless local area networks which are separated by geographical distance, then an outdoor WLAN bridge or wireless LAN bridge can be used to connect those two different wireless local area networks which are separated at a distance. So a wireless LAN connected in this type of topology is known as point to multipoint bridge topology. So what do you mean by that? I have explained again over here in this slide. Wireless bridges connect local area networks in one buildings to LANs in another buildings, even if buildings are miles apart. But the essential condition for this wireless local area network connection to take place or establish successfully in this topology is that there should be line of sight between buildings. So the line of sight condition varies based on the type of wireless LAN bridges which are used and antenna, as well as several environmental conditions. Because wireless signal is hampered by environmental conditions, and what is the transmit power of the antenna and what are the type of wireless LAN bridges are also you are using can also make a significant change in what will be the line of sight range of the communication. So what is the line of sight? The transmitter should be able to see the receiver, or the transmitted signal should be able to reach the receiver, and there should be clearly line of sight between them. So communication should not be obstructed. So, and these line of sight conditions are dependent upon three factors, that is the type of wireless local area network bridge we are using, or the configuration of the wireless bridge and the antenna, as well as other environmental conditions, as wireless signals are subjected to different types of fading and multipath propagation and so on. So a wireless local area network can be connected using three types of topology. First is peer-to-peer topology. Second one is access point based topology, and third one is this one which we discussed just now, which is point to multipoint bridge topology. So what all books you should refer while studying this course? So in under recommended reading, I would like to recommend few books. First one is Vijay K. Garg, Wireless Communication and Networking by Vijay K. Garg. Second book is Wireless and Mobile Networks Concepts and Protocol by Dr. Sunil Kumar S. Manvi, Mahabaleshwar S. Kakasagiri. Third book is Mobile Communications by Jochen Schiller. You can refer this course from multiple textbooks. These are few books given in your Mumbai University syllabus. Also, I will let you know if there are some other books related to different topics. So as of now, these three books I would like to recommend you for reading this course or studying this course. So if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe my channel, and please don't forget to click on the bell icon to get notifications of all my latest uploads. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel.